did write for wind instruments, and this is called Fell's Party because it was probably played in a field. Back in the day, the wind players were the outdoor musicians, and the strings and piano were the indoor musicians. So this is the Fell Party in C. Now we'll play the minuet, and then we end with a presto.
Mm-hmm.
10 volumes of pieces for a piano. They start really easy, and then they get really difficult by book 10. These are from books 3 and 4, and we're doing them sort of a la Hungarian street band, or which you kind of band you might hear in the subway in Prague.
Thank you. first piece you heard was called The Chi is the Glorious Flute by Joseph Haydn. And we're going to continue with another classical number from Mozart. This is called Pave Virum Corpus. You'll see some occasional adjustments in sort of musical trombones, as it were. So don't mind that. I like this sort of non-microphone forum. I'm not sure if people are watching the live stream, but hopefully you can hear me. We have a couple of composers and arrangers in our group, and I've really encouraged them to write. And one of them is one of our bass trombonists. I think he also plays violin. I think he's also an engineering.
Is it?
Yes.
He's an engineering major.
Play other? Euphonium and saxophone.
Okay, I'm pushing my luck. But he also plays euphonium, and you'll hear music. But this is an arrangement that he did of one of the great pieces for band, and it's by Gustav Holst, who, if you're familiar with, he wrote The Planets, which inspired a lot of music from Star Wars, which makes him extremely important. And this is from the second suite for band, in F. It's the fourth movement. It's called Song of the Dargazon, which I'm pretty sure means Song of the Fairy, but I think it was a dance that King Henry VIII liked to do, for what it's worth. And I'm going to play trombone. I'm not going to conduct on this, so I hope you enjoy it. But it's by our very own Kareem Dilworth.
Thank you.
This next piece we're going to play was written by someone who was a professor at Fredonia for a very, very long time, just down in the 90 there. And he was, I want to say, a tuba euphonium specialist, but he wrote a lot for brass music. And we're going to play a portion of a piece that he wrote called Canzona, and it's for 8 trombones. We are 10, which is really cool because at the beginning of the semester I thought we were only going to be 3, so we definitely wouldn't have played this piece. But here's Walter Hartley's Canzona for 8 trombones. A portion of it. If you know the piece really well, it's not the whole thing. Have two more pieces for you, and this is another, I guess it's labeled on the program as a world premiere, which it's true, that's true. I like when we can call things world premieres. There's another composer and arranger in our group who's very near and dear to my heart. He was my first student here, along with two others, just a year ago, and I've taught here for three semesters, and I unfortunately will be departing next. Departing is not the right word, but I'll be moving on to joining a military ensemble starting in the next year. But this person, Mark Bogotsky, where is he? Mark Bogotsky, he's an aspiring composer and writer, and he's a really talented guy. And he was like, "Can I write this Polish birthday song for my mom for her birthday?" And now, if you look at Mark's name in the program. Doesn't look like Bogotsky, but it's pronounced that way because he's got a deep Polish heritage. I think he's fluent. Okay, I won't say that. But I know he's traveled back and forth, and we recorded this for his mom on her birthday. I don't know if she's here, but there was one other person who had a birthday.
She's not.
No. He's also not Polish. So we're gonna dedicate this to Mark's mom. It's kind of this. I don't know if you want to talk about it at all. Stola, I wish I knew more.
Yeah, Stola basically means live 100 years. It's basically the Polish equivalent of our birthday song in English. Because we want you to live to 100.
We sure do. So please enjoy A Polish-American Birthday by Mark Bogotsky.
Thank you. Also, if it's your birthday right now, and you're Polish, it's a good day for you, if that's true. So we've just got one more, and I really want to thank all of you for being here, and I really want to thank John Nelson for just being the best and an amazing mentor and friend and teacher and trumpet player, and also Eric Huebner for my time with him, who's been extremely helpful and just a wonderful guy. So. Yeah, this is sort of my farewell to this group, although we're going to have pizza and play holiday quartets next Thursday. So if you play trombone, room B1, okay? I really thought there was only going to be 3 people in this group this semester, and there are 10. So it's just been a really special time. Every Thursday night for an hour, we've just gotten together. And every week they show up with a lot of energy, a lot more than me, and a really, really amazing attitude. So I just want to personally thank every one of them. Please stick around for the UB concert band. And this last piece is called The Razor Bones. I know. And it was commissioned by the University of Arkansas Trombone Choir, I guess. We maybe have a different name, but it's kind of a fun piece. I'm going to play again, and thanks again for listening.
Thank you.
assistant, Teresa Joizzo, will be conducting the first two pieces. Teresa Joe's a trumpet student. She also plays percussion and saxophone, and she aspires to be a music teacher. So you will enjoy her leadership for the Haydn and the Mozart.
Thank you. Thank you.
composed by John Carlo Gesualdo, is a piece from the Renaissance during a very brief period within the Renaissance, referred to as the Mannerist period, during which time artists were distorting figures in visual art, in literature, and in music. And Gesualdo's music sounds like it's going in a particular direction, and yet it doesn't. But it came before the music of Bach, Haydn, Mozart, so it's very interesting music. Gesualdo was a point of study by Igor Stravinsky, the composer of the next piece. We'll play the last two movements of his Firebird. Country Band March was written around the same time as the Stravinsky piece that you heard. And Charles Ives was interested in trying to depict a very real-life situation in his music. He grew up in Connecticut, and in Western Connecticut. And in his town, there was a town green where there would often be a band playing. There was a church, and there were church bells often playing at the same time as the band and just other kinds of activity. So in his music, he's trying to capture the idea of a band that's a little bit ragged, and that's written into the music. So when it might occur to you, what are they doing up there? Well, we're doing what's in the score. So this is the Country Band March.
Thank you.
was actually composed a little before the Ives and the Stravinsky. James Reese Europe was an African-American composer and musician that worked in Harlem, New York. He had a couple of different bands which were pretty influential in American music in that they were the first bands that employed the syncopated rhythm that's really the foundation of ragtime. And after ragtime, we had jazz. But there was no jazz without ragtime. When World War I broke out, he was contacted by the head of military bands for the US government, and he was asked to put together a band of African-American musicians, and he went around the country and auditioned people and found the best players. That band, when they served, they had to wear French uniforms because the Americans would not serve with them, even though they were American soldiers. After the war, he came back to New York and was working with his own bands, composing music until he was tragically murdered. So thank you for coming. Great band, huh? No?